Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I took a look at the items the Shrine Handmaid had for sale, and there wasn't anything particularly interesting, so I'm going to spend my 10,000 souls on a level up instead. Let's go for Dexterity.
Farewell, Ashen.
Alright, back to the Catacombs of Karthus. I hope that chamber full of like a dozen skeletons isn't going to still be there. I hope once I've defeated them once that they're forever gone. We'll see. Also, I gotta be honest. I do not remember how to get back to where I was before. I like completely forgot the layout of this place. Okay, no, I definitely go left. I remember that at least, because I came from the right. The left is where I need to go to continue. Let's go. Oh, hey. Sneaky rat. God, I really did forget almost everything. I opened up a shortcut down here, right? Yes. The skeletons are back. Shit. Does the bridge repair itself? Let's go defeat this dude and take a look at the bridge. Oh yeah, the bridge does repair itself, okay. I wonder if I can exploit that and get all the skeletons to maybe come onto the bridge? And then break it? Perhaps. Let's see if I can finally do a kick. Come on. Come on, game. Just once, please. Nope. Yeah, I was actually practicing it a little bit yesterday, and I found a way to do it more consistently, I think? And now it's not consistent at all. I don't know. Alright, I'm just gonna go. They're all gonna wake up, right? Yep, there they go. So, if I go here, I wonder where they're going to go. Are they going to follow me and jump down? Are they going to try to get to me by going across the bridge? Let's find out. Yes! Yes! I maybe did that a little bit late. Shit. Oh no, I got most of them. And the rest of them looks like they're just gonna kill themselves? I feel like this is very exploitable if you wanted to farm souls. I got 2,500 souls from that or something? That's a pretty good amount. If you kept just going back to the bonfire. And just breaking the bridge again and again, you could farm a decent amount of souls. Of course, at some point the enemies will stop spawning. Okay. This is much better. Last time I got here to this boss with no flasks. I see they haven't fixed the no texture issue. Be wary of above. A person's going like, behold the glitches! Okay. How do I fight this enemy? I didn't really figure much out other than it seems like I need to stab the hands. It's a skeleton god, very true. Try to visions of destroy, so to speak, try arm. Okay, poke the arms, gotcha. Alright, well. Guess I just gotta try it. Oh, we skipped the trap part. I don't know when it's attacking. I can't really see what's going on. Okay, I think it's attacking. Yes. This thing has a lot of health. Like, what the hell? Oh, shit. I broke one of the rings! And it took a lot of damage from that. Okay, go for the rings. What is it doing? Ew! It's vomiting mist. I'm sure it's more dangerous than normal mist. Oh wow, nice aim. You're one-handed now. One ring left. Oh shit! Oh god! Okay, I think that fog was actually like almost insta-kill you fog. It was bad breath. Very bad breath. Why did I do that? I refuse to accept that. Don't even think I triggered them all to spawn. Bye-bye! Yeah, somehow I didn't trigger them to spawn. Huh. I guess I didn't get close enough to the bridge or something. Curious what this item is. Alright, let's avoid the death smog. This item. Grave Warden Pyromancy Tome. Cool. Alright, you gonna bomb it now? Oh, shit. Alright, let's let's stay away from that. Let's wait for him to come up to me, I guess. Come on. What do you do? Whoa. Oh. Oh no. Your hand out here. Come on. Can I get this closer? Or am I gonna die? I don't know. Whoa. Now's my chance. No, wait. It's too close to the fog, I think. Come on. Stab the sword, break the sword with another sword spear. Fight fire with fire and swords with swords. At least it loses its sword when it does that. Come on, it's gotta be close to breaking. Don't get in the fog! Damn it, I should have gone for a fast attack. Summoning the sword again, I think. Yep. Man, I bet there's a serious possibility for a quick kill here. I feel like I could have broken the ring possibly before I got the sword. Oh, man. I keep dodging too late. It's alright, I got plenty of Estus. Come on. Yep. Oh, fuck. Do that, that's fine. Oh god, I'm against the wall now. I've got to end this right here, right now. I'm against the wall, there's no more room to go. Come on, put your hand down. No, don't summon it again, fuck me. If it does the AoE, I'm dead. There's nowhere to run. Other than to the side, sort of. Alright, dodged. Uh-oh. Okay, well, I'm still alive. We're good. Let me poke you! Come on, man! Come on! Thank you for the support, bird outside my window. I don't know if it's helping, though. One poke. I'll take a poke. Alright, here we go again. Ooh! Yes! Is that it? Go back to hell! That was super, super cool. I kind of wish there was more to it, though. It wasn't a very complex fight, and it was surprisingly easy. I actually wish it was a bit harder and more complicated. But I thought that was a brilliant boss fight. Aside from that, it's just brilliant in how creepy and how different it is. I'm trying to think what my favorite boss fight is in the Dark Souls, in either Dark Souls 2 or Dark Souls 3 so far. Because my favorite boss fight in Dark Souls 2, I think, was that, I don't remember what it was called, but the like, chariot horse one. I thought that was brilliant. I love that boss fight so much. I think I still like that one more, but this one might be a second place. Not really for the fight itself, but just for how creepy and interesting the idea is of fighting this giant skeleton that's slowly clawing its way up a mountainside. So cool. Be wary of dark, indeed. It's a skeleton. It is. Go for the arm, very true. Whew, okay. Alright, I'm gonna continue on in this place in just a little bit, but before that I want to give the pyromancy tome to the pyromancy guy, and I also want to see what I can make using the new soul that I just got.
I'm afraid I cannot accept this.
Hmm?
This pyromancy tome is dark and delves into the depths of men where an untouchable flame resides. I cannot comprehend this myself, let alone teach it to you. It is a spell forbidden in the Great Swamp, and nearly everywhere else too. Only one terribly afflicted or burdened by deep sorrow could begin to understand this.
Interesting. I guess at some point you can give it to someone else.
Do not be God.
Alright, let's see what I can make with that soul. Tweet, tweet, tweet. Man, those towhees are sure loud.
Aha, thou good soul.
Alright. So it's Soul of High Lord Wolnir. Oh, that reminds me. Actually, before I do... Oh, no! That's what I get for trying to back out of dialogue too fast. Backed out of dialogue, and then I backed out of life. That makes it sound like I killed myself. That's not what I meant to say. Yeah, let's get the description for it. Lord Wolnir of Karthus sentenced countless souls to gruesome deaths, keen to outlive them all. What a swell guy.
Ah.
Okay, so how many things can I make with it? That's two. Okay, so I can make two things. I can make this, which is a pyromancy thing. Release undulating black flame that runs along the ground. Is that what I encountered? Was that actually a black flame? Not poison or whatever it is? Whatever I thought it was? Or I can make a great sword. Wolnir's holy sword. That scales very poorly. A holy sword eroded by the abyss. When Wolnir fell to the abyss, he was gripped by a fear of true darkness and pleaded to the gods for the first time. This holy sword, together with three armlets stripped from the corpses of clerics, gave him some semblance of comfort. When the skill is Wrath of the Gods, thrust the weapon into earth to emit powerful shockwave. Oh, so it's like a mini version of what they did to me in the boss fight. How heavy is this? Or what are its requirements, rather? Oh, for a greatsword, the requirements are actually super reasonable. Except it requires faith or intelligence, whatever that one is to the right, which I don't have anywhere near enough of. Okay, well, it's safe to say I'm not going to be ever making either of these things, because these both are kind of mage items. So, you know what I really want to do is buy the 40,000 soul thing from the Firekeeper that allows her to get rid of my dark sign or dark sigil. So I've got 25,000 right now. So what I'm actually going to do is see how many souls I get from using Lord Wolnir's soul. Since I'm not going to make any items out of it, I might as well pop it. Alright, how many are you going to give me? 10,000. Okay, I'm pretty close. So let's go for another one of the other souls that I'm not going to use. Actually, should I? Or should I just... I probably have enough of the lesser souls to actually give me 5,000. I've got these large souls. Perhaps I should use those. Let's see how much this gives me. Oh, wow. There we go. So let's see what this does. I hope it makes me look pretty again. It did!
Farewell.
I am beautiful again. The only thing that concerns me is...
Welcome to speak.
You have no dark sigil.
Farewell, Ashne the Flint.
So, I started out as human. I mean, looking human. And then at some point, I just ended up looking dead. Is it going to happen again if I die a certain amount of times and I'm going to have to heal it again? Because if so, that's going to get very expensive. Also, aside from making me human, which, I mean, I think that's enough, just it feels nice to be human again. But aside from that, did that actually do anything practical? I really don't know. Eh, I guess I'll look at the wiki if I want to know how that works. Let's go back to adventuring. I mean, well, actually, hold on, there's... You can see in the top left of the screen, right below my stamina, there's a couple, like, status effects listed there. The first one is my stamina up. I'm not sure what the other two are, but one of those could perhaps be the Dark Sigil thing. The only thing is, I don't actually know how to check the status effects. Like, where are they listed? As far as what they do. I don't know, whatever. That is beautiful. That is gorgeous. Oh my god. It's snowing and it looks like there's sort of a Northern Lights thing going on. Think carefully. Hmm? About what? I'm trying to look around for landmarks to see where if I can identify places I came from. There's a huge tree up there, but I don't quite remember what tree that might be. Wasn't there a large... No, that tree wasn't big enough. Never mind. I'm not sure. Don't give up. Always a good message to see. There's enemies down there in the water, so obviously I'm going to be able to go down there at some point. God, this really is just beautiful. And looking at this, I'm getting a really strong Bloodborne kind of feel. It feels sort of, Victorian? Kind of? Be wary of pointless. Thank you for warning me. Something's gonna kill me on this bridge. Right, so there's gonna be like a dragon or something. Whoa. Bring a doll to be granted passage. Where would I get a doll? Do I have a doll? I don't think I have a doll. No, I don't have a doll. If I just had a doll. Where would I get a doll, though? I mean, I think I've been, like, everywhere I can possibly be before coming here. So I don't think it'd be something I'd pick up. Was there one for sale at the Shrine Handmaid? I don't think so. Oh my God. Also, I need to look backwards when I'm going across the bridge because I want to know where that thing's coming from. Oh, it just teleports in? Okay. Jesus Christ. I think I can only dodge and then do one hit. It's gonna take a lot of dodging and a lot of hits. Whew, okay. I'm not sure if this is what they mean by being granted passage. It's possible the granting passage thing would happen later on. Like, maybe this isn't even what they mean? Eh, it might be. It probably is. Or maybe I get the doll from the enemy? How did that hit me? Come on, axe. That was pathetic. Oh my god, I can't even hit it. Ooh, hitting its head does way more damage. Don't get greedy. Don't get greedy. I got this, just gotta be patient. Pontiff's right eye. Didn't I already make that? Don't tell me Pontiff had two right eyes. When I was testing that ring last episode, did I never re-equipped a ring? Whoops! Which one am I? Oh, wow, okay. I meant to have the Estus ring on, that would've helped. Anyway, Pontiff's right eye. Oh no! It's left and right, okay. That makes me feel more comfortable. So this one is the one I made before that recovers HP with successive attacks, except it actually doesn't seem to do anything for some reason. This one boosts attack as long as attacking persists. Knights who peer into the black orb are lured into battles of death, transformed into frenzied beasts. That's the same description as the other one, isn't it? Yeah, exact same description, except for the part about what it actually does. I mean, this one doesn't seem to actually heal. Is this one really gonna do anything? I don't know. Maybe I'll try it at some point, but not right now. You know, I should probably go back. That was most likely a one-time enemy. I should go back and get my Estus. If that's not a one-time enemy, I'm gonna cry. Ooh, I've got like 10,000 souls. I should maybe go level up. Nah. Please be a one-time enemy. Alright, we're good. Is this what I need to be granted passage into? This wavy wall? Those who do not hold the doll cannot pass. Uh-oh. I really do need a doll. Huh. What doll? I guess I did miss something. There's nowhere else I can go here, right? No cracks in the bridge, ladders. Hmm. Like, is there something back here? I mean... Where have I missed? Well, before I do something stupid and lose all of my souls while searching for the missing pathway, let's level up. I'm gonna put one more point into endurance to get a couple more stamina.
Farewell, Ashen, may the flame.
Okay. Well, I looked around in the catacombs down there, looking for something that I missed, and it looks like, as far as I can tell, I've missed nothing. I guess the catacombs are actually just pretty small. So in the end, I ended up having to Google where to find the doll, and apparently you get it from defeating a boss that is somewhere around the Road of Sacrifices, so I missed something very big here. I missed an entire pathway that leads to a boss. So let's go find it. They said something about heading left and you find a bonfire in like a ruined keep or something. Right, so where have I been? I know I've been over there. Front right leads to that hard enemy. I know there's like a fortress over there. Well, they said head left, so I guess let's just stay left. It really does look like there's a pathway up there. Okay, I remember going here before, I remember fighting these enemies. Nice. Yep, I've already been here before. That loot. So I've already been here. I know I've already been down here. That leads to the enemy where I fell down there and I kept dying. There's nothing down there. This leads up to the fortress. Oh hey, it's another thing I never got. Whoa! I didn't think they'd have a full set of armor on them. Cool. Oh, what about here where I defeated those two... Yeah, those two people. Did I ever go this way? Maybe this is where I never went. No. This leads to the swamp, right? I think. Yeah, that leads to the swamp. And this goes nowhere. Yeah, so this isn't it. They said it was before Farron's Keep, and I believe this is the Farron's Keep bonfire down here. So... not quite here. Oh, let's go look at the armor before I forget it. This Fallen Knight armor. Ooh, it's quite heavy. Yep, it is significantly better at... most things, except significantly worse at poison, frost, and curse. But it's so heavy. Then again, I am only at 44% weight. I can go up to 70 without slow rolling. Man, that armor looks really patchy. It is significantly better, but man, the resistances are so bad. Ugh. Well, let's equip it all and see if I'm still under 70%. Well, that's weird. This one's actually worse at strike and slash. Okay, well, I'm only at 58%, so my rolling speed is still going to be the same. I look kind of badass. I just wish I didn't have those rags on the outside. If it had everything but that, I think it'd look even cooler. I kind of like it, though. I think I'm going to stick with it. Okay, so, missed something. I've got an idea. Let me go back through here. It might be somewhere inside of this building. Falling down here. There's an item down there. Already did that. It looks like somebody jumped onto there. No! Oh well. Right, that's the kind of like shortcut that allows you to get kind of behind the enemies. Did I ever go this way? Yeah. Yeah, I've already been here. I fell down the hole. Maybe there's something this way. This is where I found the NPC, the sorcery guy. Ow. There's a pathway down there, or there's a doorway that leads somewhere that I don't remember going. Perhaps it's there. Perhaps. I remember this room was really dangerous. Good one. Come on. You can do it. I believe in you. A lot of damage. Come on, don't split up, no. Alright, we're good. Okay, so is this a pathway? Oh, this is, isn't it? Yeah, I never went up here. Oh, I only went to the side. Okay, this is what I missed. Alright, we're good. Sorcerer ahead. Sage ahead. Oh, are we going straight into the boss fight? Because I believe what people said is I needed to defeat the Crystal Sage, I think it was called, that had the doll. This does look like a boss arena. Maybe the only thing I missed was the boss fight, and there's nothing more. Here we go. Ow. Okay, lots of crystals. Right. Ooh, what's up here? Nothing. There's nothing up here. What's the point of this? Other than, I guess it's kind of safe here. Uh-oh, AoE? Or something? Oh no, it's moving. Huh? What's happening? I don't know if these things, like, hurt if I touch them? Should I bother breaking them? I don't know. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh. Oh no. Okay, that was an illusion. This is getting more complicated. I do want to defeat those crystal things, or they will turn into crystal lies. This is the real one. Okay, well, we've almost got her. Okay, defeat them! Oh my god, come on, come on, come on, come on! No! No! Jesus Christ! What the fuck? Oh no, oh no, no! Fuck! I was so close! Okay, well this fight starts out really, really easy. But then it just gets chaotic. I'm not really sure what to do. Is there really no bonfire closer to the Crystal Sage, though? Because, damn, that's far away. I feel like I'm missing a bonfire. I'm just gonna run there. Uh-oh, this might not be the best way to go. Alright, well I'm committed. Okay, if you get the real one, the others disappear. It's worth noting. It might not be worth trying to take out all the adds. Just, well, I guess you can't tell if they're adds until you've tried them. Okay, I'm getting kind of lucky here, although I'm not getting many hits in. Oh, the real one again. All right, here we go. That one is fake. Okay, oh god. This one is real. Oh man. Okay, a couple more hits. Full health. Let's go. Let's go. Bring it on. Fake. 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 I want to make sure I have plenty of stamina. Real one! Yes! Ah, soul of a crystal sage. That, however, is not a doll. Where is the doll? Probably further on ahead. If there's another pathway, I think I saw one. The twin crystal sages once served as spiritual guides to the scholars of the Grand Archives, and one went on to ally with the Undead Legion. I guess this would be the one I just fought. They seemed rather undead. So this is the bonfire they were talking about. It's not before the boss, it's after the boss. Fair enough. And I do believe this is a further pathway to go on. Yes. Okay. So I guess the doll is further on ahead. Let's go spend my souls. And also take a look at what I can transpose with that soul. Sold crystal sage, so it's two items. Okay, so these two. Cast cascade of small crystal soul masses from sky. Obviously not going to get that. Oh! Rapier! It's a thrusting sword. It sounds like another S-Dog. Oh no, but it scales with some sort of magic. Ah, dang, it's not for me then. It doesn't actually require any, whatever that is, intelligence, I think. It doesn't actually require any, but it does scale with it, which means it'd be very inefficient for me to use it without, you know, really putting any points into that. And also, its scaling in strength and dexterity is horrendous. E. A, B, C, D, E. Very bad. But still, if I was, an assassin class that actually focused on magic, this would probably be a very interesting weapon. It looks beautiful, from what I can see from the picture. Thrusting sword with tiny crystals scattered across its blade, used by the crystal sages for self-defense. The crystals boost the magic damage inflicted by the sword, and the item discovery of its wielder, fruits of the lifetime of research conducted by the sages. So just by having this equipped, you actually discover more items. Interesting. You know, I'm not actually going to use that. But I really want to see it.
Treat the firekeeper.
That sounds so interesting. And the base damage is... the base physical damage is very bad, but it has quite a bit of magic damage. Yeah, very long sword. Definitely seems on par with the S-Dock in length. Got crystals coming off it. That is a beautiful weapon. Now let's check out the attacks. Simple thrust for the light attack. Let's do the heavy attack. Big thrust. Okay. Now this one seemed very special from what I was reading. This is the stance. This is the, like, the special attack. If you do the stance and then do a light attack... Oh, that is so cool! So if you enter a stance and you do a light attack, you dodge backwards and then attack forwards. That is very cool. Okay, then what if we do a strong attack? Oh, that used so much FP. Look at how much that used. Well, actually, maybe not as much as I thought. It's still quite a bit, though, compared to the light attack. Actually, no, I think it uses about the same as a light attack. Never mind. But that is so cool. That is so cool. Oh my god. Talk about poking him full of holes. Oh, I wish I could use this weapon. But it just doesn't make any sense for my character. Damn. Ah, well, maybe I'll find another cooler weapon. Still, in the meantime, I have Arstor's Spear, which is also pretty damn cool. I mean, Jesus, it's a spear covered in rotting flesh that restores hit points when I attack enemies, and also poisons them. That's pretty cool. Oh, which one was it? This one. Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm gonna hopefully find the doll.